Now, in paganism, the focus of love, there is love, but that love is focused on self-gain, self-profit, self-gain, and self-benefit. Whereas, in Christianity, there is love as well. But the focus of love in Christianity is for another. You know, there is this concept that has come from motivational speakers and some pastors and churches, American churches, that are mainly motivational churches that are practicing motivational thinking, and they teach this: or you cannot love your others if you don't love yourself. That's not what God the Bible said. Anybody who goes to church because they want to get something, and you know, the thing they want to get is not to get to know God, it's not to get the knowledge of God, it's not to discover his character, his nature, it's not to discover his virtues and his principles to be able to copy him, be like him. If that is not the reason you are going to church, and you are going to church to be blessed by him, to give you some blessings and to, you know, make your life better, it means selfishness is driving you. That is paganism. But in churches in Africa, nobody teaches you how to love God after you've got saved. They rather begin to teach you in such a way that it's you become even the more the center of your life. You even begin to think that God is there only for you, that God is existing just for you. So that, I'm saying that there is no love. The biblical love is not being preached in Nigeria and in Africa. And the proof is that if there is no way biblical love will be preached, and people will be passing by, millions of destitutes, of hungry people, mad people, naked people, abandoned children, poor women, market women, they will be passing them by the millions every day on their way to church. We are not even saying on their way to job again. We are not even talking about on their way to the home. The overwhelming problems and things that need attention every day in every street of Nigeria, there are so many that you will not even believe there is a Christian in that whole country. We don't have a concept that my neighbor is me, that every human being around me is the image of God just like me. But in Africa, you know what matters? The only thing that matters in Africa is your own, is you and your parents and relatives. In fact, in Africa, people will say, since you are not related to me, on what basis should I help you? People don't understand love, that on the basis that that person is a human being, on the basis that that person is born of God like you, on the basis that that person is made in the image and likeness of God. In fact, let me tell you worse things. Even Christians who go to church every Sunday, I'm planning to go to heaven. I don't even know what heaven they are planning to go to. I don't know. I don't have an idea what heaven. Because I doubt it that people are going to go to heaven. The gospel of love, the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ is all about love. And we need to return it. We need to bring it back to the altar of Africa, of the African Pentecostal churches. We need to begin to demonstrate it. We need to begin to let people know that it is more important to love people in the street than to come to church. It is more important to care about the homeless than to care about the pastor. It is more important to care about the people, the children in the street, than to build a new church cathedral. If there is no love, there is no Christianity, my dear. There are some pastors who are now teaching that kind of doctrine from hell. That if you will give to the poor man, you yourself will become poor. I think all of us should want to ask ourselves, so what kind of messages do we preach in our churches? If there are so many churches, because Nigeria boasts themselves the greatest building in the world, the largest church building in the world, the largest congregation, the biggest church, the richest pastors. You know, out of 10 richest pastors in the world, 9 of them are from my country. So what do they teach as love in Nigerian church? The Christian love is this: God has already loved us. He has already proved his love to us by dying for us. Now, my response, our Christianity in Nigeria, they don't preach to you about your own response to God's love. That God has died for you already. Now, you need to learn to love him. That's the way it's supposed to be preached. Now that he has died for you, now you must get to know him. To know his nature and character. And what is the biggest nature of God? The biggest nature of God is that God is love.